Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is your brother Majed Mahmoud, continuing with the second episode of Understanding Allah's Beautiful Names. The nobility of a science is proportional to the majesty of the object of study. So an example, the engineer versus the doctor. Which one in the society, in your society perhaps, is of a higher status, the doctor or the engineer? You would most likely, the doctor is of a higher status than the engineer. Why? Because the object of study for the doctor is what? Human beings. Maybe the brain, the bones, the muscles, whatever it may be. But the object of study for the engineer are what? Machines, tools, metals, steel, whatever it may be. So because the object of study of the doctor is of a higher status than the one of the engineer, that makes the doctor of a higher status. Now, question that comes and follows. When your object of study is Allah's beautiful names, what status does that make you in? When you're learning or teaching about Allah's beautiful names, don't you go over the engineer and above the doctor? Because there's nothing on the face of this earth that is more valuable and honorable than Allah's beautiful names and learning them and living with these beautiful names. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to benefit from them and not just hearing and wasting our time and entertaining ourselves, rather hearing and obeying and implementing in a way that we gain Allah's pleasure. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Brothers and sisters, those who truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would truly love whatever it is in a way that they can learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And since these episodes allow you to learn more about Allah, then the true lovers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true lovers, will learn and put the time to learn about these names. Now pay attention. I'm not telling you to specifically watch this series. A'udhu billah. The point that I'm trying to get to is you putting the effort to learn them somehow through a book that's very clearly and detailed, explained nicely, through another speaker, through whatever it means that are proper and authentic, then go for it, inshallah. But the true lovers will definitely put the effort to learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look, for example, at another person who truly loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and didn't want to let go of Allah and was willing to sacrifice his life as many times as possible, but sadly there's only one life to sacrifice. Similar to the story of Abdullah ibn Hudhafa, but this story which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, it's a story that is even beyond the story of Abdullah ibn Hudhafa and al-Khansa, a story where Allah, it's an authentic hadith. And by the way, important disclaimer, every hadith I'm mentioning is authentic inshallah, unless I say otherwise, or of course I make a mistake. This hadith is authentic where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu. One time he was sad, he was depressed, crying. So the Prophet said, Ya Jabir, ma li araka munkasiran. Ya Jabir, how come I'm seeing you like sad and anxious and depressed? Like, were you crying? Like, what's wrong, Ya Jabir? He said, Ya Rasulullah, istushhida abi, my father got killed in the Ghazwat Uhud, in the Battle of Uhud, Ya Rasulullah. And he left a lot of children behind and he left a lot of debt, Ya Rasulullah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَفَلَا أُبَشِّرُكَ بِمَا لَقِيَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَبَاكَ. Shall I not tell you of something that will make you very happy and a glad tiding of what your father witnessed when he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never talked to a person except that there was a hijab, there was a barrier, except when he talked to your father. When he talked to your father, there was no barrier. It was Allah and Abdullah, the father of Jabir. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Abdullah, the one who's dead as a martyr now, he said, make a wish, make a wish. He said, Ya Allah, I wish that I shall go back to the dunya and fight once again and lose my life once again for your sake, Ya Allah. For how beautiful and sweet it was to sacrifice his life to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, what a wish is this, subhanallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I cannot do that because I made a promise that those who die shall never come back to the dunya. So then Abdullah asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if that's the case, then please let the people on this earth know of my status and where I'm at right now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed that verse that many of us perhaps have heard. It came in this authentic hadith where Allah said in Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, verse 169, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتًا. And don't think that those who died in the path of Allah are dead. Rather, بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. Rather, they're alive with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala providing them. Allahu Akbar. They're not dead. And this ayah was revealed because of the father of Jabir radiallahu anhu. You might ask, brother, how can we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There are multiple ways. A book which you can read, or a world which you can see. The book which you can read can be the Quran and Sunnah. So the first route, the Quran and Sunnah, you get to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more. Look, for example, in the Quran, what was the first verse revealed? What was the first verse? Read it. Bismillah. Aywa. Allah said in the Quran, exactly. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Read by the name of Allah. That was the first verse. Read by the name of Allah, the one who has created. Subhanallah. That was chapter 96, verse number 1. How do we begin every surah? When we're going to recite from the Quran, every surah, how do you start? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When Allah created Adam alayhi salam, what did Allah say in chapter 2, verse 31? Allah said, وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا. And Allah taught Adam all the names. The tree is a tree, the lamp is a lamp, the sun is the sun, the sand is sand. But doesn't logic tell me and you that the first set of names that Allah taught Adam were Allah's beautiful names? Subhanallah. What about looking at the greatest verse in the Quran? When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, Ya Aba al-Mundhir, O Aba al-Mundhir, the kunya, so the father of al-Mundhir. Do you know which verse in the Quran is the greatest verse in the Quran? Abul Mundhir, with respect, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us people of respect and akhlaq and good manners. Just the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam when he used to look at himself and he say, Allahumma ahsin khuluqi kam ahsanta khalqi. Oh Allah, beautify my manners. Just like how you beautified my external features. We ask Allah to grant such akhlaq like Abul Mundhir. And Abul Mundhir, even though he knew the answer, he said, Allahu wa rasuluhu alam, Allah and the messenger know best. But the Prophet insisted. He said, Ya Abul Mundhir, which verse in the Quran is the greatest verse? And don't forget, every time you say Rasulullah sallallahu, you send your salah and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And never stop. Wallahi, if the only thing you get out of these episodes, the only thing is saying sallallahu alayhi wasallam, every time you hear that beautiful name, wallahi, it's a great blessing. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward us every time we say it. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Then Abul Mundhir, when he saw the Prophet insisting on getting an answer for that question, he said, Ya Rasulullah, it is Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. It is Allah, the one, there's no deity worthy of worship except Him. Al-hayy, the all-living. Al-qayyum, the dominating. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his hand, he tapped on the chest of Abul Mundhir and he said, لِيَهْنَكَ الْعِلْمُ Abul Mundhir. May knowledge be pleasant for you, Abul Mundhir. Allahu Akbar. And you might wonder, why is this verse the best and the greatest verse in the whole Quran? Even though all verses are great, but this is the greatest one, just like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Because this verse explains to us who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. Go to chapter number 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 255. And bi'idhnillah, all of us memorized it. And if you didn't memorize it, please take it as a homework. I ask you by Allah. I ask you by Allah to go and master memorizing this ayah. Master the pronunciation that when Allah la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wala nawm. It shows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't doze away and doesn't fall asleep. Lahu ma fi as-samawati wa ma fi al-ard. To Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. Man dhal ladhi yashfa'u 'indahu illa bi idhnih. Who can intercede without getting the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum. He knows whatever is in front of them and whatever is behind them. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. And they only get to know only what Allah made visible to them, what He made available for them. And Allah says, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And Allah's kursi is bigger than the heavens and the earth in a way that befits His majesty. And that kursi, how it looks like, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And Allah says, وَلَا يَؤُدُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا. And it's not difficult on Allah to protect and to safeguard these places and these things. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Ali, the exalted, al-Azim, the greatest. Look how it explains Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And obviously there's much of a better tafsir that you can read. But please memorize it. An action item. Memorize this ayah. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't forget sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will always remind you inshaAllah as much as I can. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever reads Ayatul Kursi in the morning, Allah protects that person from evil until the night. Allah protects him, that person, from the shayateen till the night. And whoever reads Ayatul Kursi at the night, Allah protects that person from shayateen and the evil until the morning. So bi-ithnillah, in the morning and the evening, Ayatul Kursi, it will take you seconds inshaAllah. Now look how the Quran is full of teaching us who Allah is. And this ayah has a lot of names. Al-Hayy, Al-Qayyum, Al-Ali, Al-Azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful. Now look also in the Quran and the Sunnah. The Prophet taught us, before we eat, what shall we say? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the hadith that is authentic, he said, there is a surah in the Quran that is equivalent to 1/3 of the Quran. Surah is this. What do you think? I'll give you a few seconds to think about it. Which surah in the Quran is equivalent to 1/3 of the Quran? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ, I swear by the one whom my soul is in his hands, إِنَّهَا لَتَعْدِلُ ثُلُثَ الْقُرْآنِ. This surah, which is Surah Al-Ikhlas, is equivalent to 1/3 of the Quran. Inshallah, I'll mention a little more points about how do we get to know Allah through the Quran and through the Sunnah after this short break, inshallah. So please stay tuned. I'll see you shortly. Jazakum Allah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And very quick, if it was morning, read Ayatul Kursi. If it was the evening, read Ayatul Kursi. Whatever time zone you're in right now, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Islamic International School presents Determination, Motivation and Spirituality.
The most valuable thing in your life is Iman.
Revive history for soul purification.
The true peace of the soul, the true peace and the tranquility.
Meet the revolutionary Dais of the era.
My respected elders
and my dear brothers and sisters,
I welcome all of you.
I welcome all of you.
I welcome all of you.
I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Watch Dais of the Islamic International School in Next Generation, next on Peace TV. The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqoo mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK, B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you for tuning in. After the break, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this episode and bless those that are watching. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. When you look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends the ayat in the Quran, many ayat, with names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pay attention. Allah doesn't randomly do it. Allah doesn't put random names, Sami', Basir, Aziz, Hakim, just like that. However, they're placed with full wisdom, for Allah is Al-Hakim, the All-Wise. You look at an ayah, for example, in chapter number 2, verse 260. Allah says the conversation that He had with Ibrahim alayhi salam Allah says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Ibrahim told his Lord, Ya Allah, show me, how do you bring the dead to life? Then Allah says, قَالَ أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ. Oh Ibrahim, you didn't fully believe yet? He said, قَالَ بَلَى وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. Just for my heart to be rest assured. قَالْ فَخُذْ أَرْبَعَةَ مِنَ الطَّيْرِ. Okay Ibrahim, take four birds. فَخُذْ أَرْبَعَةَ مِنَ الطَّيْرِ فَصُرْهُنَّ إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ اجْعَلْ عَلَى كُلِّ جَبَلٍ مِنْهُنَّ جُزْءًا. Bring these birds, cut them apart, put each part on a mountain. Then Allah says in the Quran, ثُمَّ ادْعُهُنَّ يَأْتِينَكَ السَّعِيَ. Then call upon these birds and they'll come to you. The birds will come together. The wing that you ripped apart will come from this mountain to the other mountain, etc. Then Allah says, وَعْلَمْ. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. So Allah puts Aziz and Hakim together for a reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put this ayah for you to understand and comprehend these two names. Allah is the Almighty, Al-Aziz. He's able to do anything. So powerful. Subhanallah, the Almighty, Al-Hakim, the All-Wise. Allah Al-Hakim, He has a wisdom of why we die on this time and where do we die and that location and all these wisdom behind it, Allah Al-Hakim knows about it. And obviously there's much more meanings behind that as well. For example, you can go and you see in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. This is the point in the Quran where Allah says that you use my name and call me and make dua with these names and customize your dua. So you need something specific, then go with that name. So you want, for example, Allah to bless you with a beautiful and a great job. What name would you choose? Allah Ar-Razzaq. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you sense that Allah loves. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you a loving person. You use which name? Allah Al-Wadud. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His mercy upon you, upon your family, upon your children. Which name do you use? Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, for example. Allah has these two names. So there's multiple things. So customize your dua because Allah said in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. طيب. Now, next time we read the Quran, we will read with the intention of knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask you, please, next time you read an ayah that ends with Allah's names, don't just pass by just like normally and randomly, but think about it. So next time you read, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ. If you've been reading this surah for the longest time, and you don't know Allah as-samad means, then I ask you, go back and read fully and more. What does as-samad mean? Because the next time you read it, the next time you go, and inshallah, you will actually feel it. I'll give you in brief. As-Samad is the one whom we all go to for help and the one who needs no one's help. The one we all rush to him. Help us, Ya Allah, As-Samad. And he is the one who needs no one's help and he's not in need of anyone, subhanAllah. This is the Quran. This is the Sunnah which we can read. Let's look at the other way where we can know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a world which we can see. Look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't forget, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before he became a prophet, he was in Ghar Hira. He was in the Ghar for the longest time, pondering upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Looking at the Kaaba, he was able to see the Kaaba from the Ghar. And looking at the idols around. And the prophet, it never made sense to him. How can rocks be lords? How can rocks be ones that deserves a sajda prostration? And subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never made a single sajda in his life to an idol. And this pondering increased his iman, as if it was preparing him to become the final messenger who was sent as mercy to all mankind. Look at Surah Al-Talaq. Surah Al-Talaq, Allah says in the Quran, in chapter 65, verse 12. You might say, brother, you said a world which you can see. Yes, but look at the ayah, what does it say? Allah says, الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created seven heavens and similarly of those in the earth. يتنزل الأمر بينهن. His command descends among them. Why is Allah telling us this? Continue. لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير. So Allah created the heavens and the earth and the order descends and all this. Why? For us to know. لِتَعْلَمْ. So you may know and may I know as well. What? That Allah is capable of doing everything and anything. And another thing for us to know. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. And for you to know that Allah is knowledgeable and is aware of everything in the world. Allahu Akbar. When you look at the heavens and the earth, When you look at the sky and how there are no pillars that are visible to our eyes and how they're still being held up there, know that Allah is Al-Qadir. When you see that, subhanAllah, all this body and the biology and the cells and our blood is so perfect the way it operates, then know that there's a knowledgeable figure behind that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Alim. So Allah shows us this creation so we can be introduced to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the four seasons. Look at the spring, the fall, the winter, the summer, and how they go one after the other. To tell you that we will soon die and we will soon be resurrected. To tell you that the one who's controlling this cycle is definitely someone that will always be living and will never die. And many more meanings that you can perhaps, you might give better meanings than what I just mentioned right now. When you go and you ponder and you feel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we're going to move forward to some technicalities and some little academics here and there, just to better understand how we view Allah's beautiful names. Number one, how many names does Allah have? Huh? Quick, are you with your, sitting with your family? Ask that question. How many names do you guys think that Allah has? Some people would say Allah has 99 names. That is correct to a certain extent. If you tell me Allah only has 99 names, I'll tell you, sorry, brother and sister, that's a little misconception right there. But Allah does have much more than 99 names. But brother, you just mentioned a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 100 minus 1 names. I said absolutely, which means 99. However, it does not mean He only has 99 names. If I tell you, I love my daughter Maryam, for example, I love my daughter Maryam, does that mean I only have one daughter? No. But actually, I have two daughters, alhamdulillah. May Allah bless them, and may Allah bless your children, and may Allah bless them and make them among those that live with Allah's names and die upon the kalima, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where the Prophet says in authentic hadith, أَسْأَلُكَ بِكُلِّ اسْمٍ هُوَ لَكَ. O Allah, I ask you by every name that belongs to you. سَمَّيْتَ بِهِ نَفْسَكَ, a name which you called yourself. أَوْ أَنزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ, or you made that name descend in one of the books. أَوْ عَلَّمْتَهُ أَحَدًا مِنْ خَلْقِكَ, or you taught certain names to certain of your creation. أَوْ اسْتَأْثَرْتَ بِهِ فِي عِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ عِنْدَكَ, or you kept some names hidden, secret only in the unseen. So with this hadith and this dua, obviously there's more words to this dua, and there's more words before, but I just took that part about the names to tell you that there are names beyond those that we know, and there are names that are actually more than 99 names. Now, something very, very important that comes when it comes to Allah's beautiful names is that Asma'illahi ta'ala tawqifiyya, which means Allah's names can be derived from the Quran and Sunnah and cannot be man-made. You cannot make up a name without an evidence. You can't do that. So we cannot, for example, it's wrong to say, since the world is very nicely engineered, you cannot say Allah is the engineer. You can't do that. You have to find an evidence from the Quran and Sunnah. Is it clear? For example, sometimes people think, since my name is Majed, then one of Allah's names is Al-Majid. But I would tell our brothers and sisters that say that, what's your evidence that Allah's name is Al-Majid? You have to get something from the Quran or Sunnah. Is it clear? Something very, very important. طيب. Now, what's the difference between a name and an attribute? There are two different things. Pay attention. Every name has an attribute, and not every attribute is a name. So a name, for example, a Samir, it is a proper name to call Allah, something that is befitting, and Allah called Himself a Samir. And it conveys the meaning which Allah that He hears. For an attribute, for example, if you go to an attribute, Allah says in the Quran, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَالضَّالِينَ, so not among those whom Allah is angry upon. This is an attribute, but you cannot call Allah is Al-Ghadban, that Allah is the angry one. That's not a befitting name and a kind name to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's just an attribute. So every name has an attribute, and not every attribute is a name. How do we feel towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how do we view it? We view Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful names in a way that we do not distort, لا تحريف, we do not deny, we don't have ta'atil, we don't liken Allah to His creation, لا ليس هناك تمثيل, and we don't discuss how, there's no takyif. So ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. So if I tell you Allah is a Sami, or Allah says in the Quran in chapter 42, verse 11, ليس كمثله شيء, there's nothing like Allah, and He is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. So it means, as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe, that arkan al-iman bil asma al-husna, that the way we believe in Allah's beautiful names is that the name befits Allah. For example, as-sami', yes, it is Allah's name. We believe it has a meaning, Allah hears. And we believe that that meaning is manifested, which means when we speak, Allah hears us. So we believe Allah is ar-Rahman. That means He made mercy upon mankind. And it means that His mercy falls upon us when we ever ask for it, whether we do ask ar-Rahim or ar-Rahman, and we'll go in details afterwards. So this means we don't stop them, and we don't change the meaning or distort it. We never do that. We call whatever Allah called Himself, and whatever Rasulullah ﷺ told in the hadith that Allah's name is so and so. Jazakum Allah khair for your patience. I'll see you inshallah next episode. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Say Allah.